Imagine you are buying a car and your car does not have any dashboard. So what will happen? Similarly, when you buy a storage array, you need to have a very world-class observability tool, because buying a storage without observability is like driving a car without a dashboard. You may keep moving, but you do not know when you are going to run out of fuel, when your car is going to overheat, or you're headed for a breakdown. Now, having said that, now that I have established that we need a world-class observability tool when you buy a storage box, what are the critical operational questions that this tool can answer for you? And that I call it the 7 pillars of observability. So what are those pillars? Number one, availability. Is my storage infrastructure available? Does it have enough availability for my applications? This is the very basic question a storage admin needs to know. Hence, that's the first pillar. Second, performance. Is my storage infrastructure performing well? Does it give enough resources to my applications? How is it doing with respect to latency and IOPS? These are the critical questions that a world-class observability tool can answer once the storage array is configured. Now I moved into a very critical one, the third one, capacity. Do I have enough capacity now? What is that capacity I was using in the past? When is my box running going to run out of capacity? How can I order more capacity when it's going to run out? Next, and the very important pillar in the recent days has become security. Is my storage infrastructure secure? Do I have enough safety against the ransomware attacks? Is my security posture configured correctly? How do I know? This tool can answer those questions and make me safe. The next one, inventory. What does my inventory look like? How many block storage devices I have? How many file storage devices I have? How many of them are hyperconverged? All these critical questions, so that I can plan my storage infrastructure better, can be answered when I know what my inventory has, right? Cost. What is the current cost I am paying for my storage infrastructure? How much is my cost going to escalate? Is my cost going to go out of a limit? Only my world-class observability tool can help, and hence, this is a very critical part. And last, but not the least, sustainability. Is my storage infrastructure doing well with respect to power consumption? What is it taking for carbon emissions? Is my infrastructure aligning with my carbon goals? What does the data say? Now, this is where my storage observability tool will help align my box. Now, having answered all the critical operational questions via 7 pillars of observability, let's look at use cases where the observability tool is a must-have for storage boxes. The use cases that can help the admin to manage your storage infrastructure better. What are those use cases? End-to-end visibility. In a storage infrastructure, there are many components, from the host to switches to the storage box. And you want to know all the paths from your applications and till the storage, what's exactly the thing. So it helps teams understand how storage systems, applications, and infrastructure are interconnected to eliminate blind spots. Next, proactive issue detection. By monitoring health, performance, and anomalies in real time, this enables early detection and faster resolution of issues before they impact, right? Performance optimization. For a big time a storage admin has a problem, how is my latency? How is my IOPS? How is my throughput? Now, if a world-class observability tool, it can provide insights into the workloads, bottlenecks, and utilization patterns, ensuring optimal performance and resource allocation. Next, capacity planning and cost management. How am I doing with respect to capacity? With a world-class storage observability tool, the usage trends and predictive analytics, a storage admin can plan the storage growth, avoid over-provisioning, which is critical, and reduce unnecessary costs, right? In a data center today, in common data centers, there are generally multi-vendor and hybrid environments. A world-class storage observability tool simplifies management across different storage vendors, and if whether it is on-prem or cloud, ensuring consistency and reducing complexity. It improves reliability by continuously monitoring, reducing the downtime risks, and enhances resilience against failures because of multiple upgrades or multiple security threats. With all this, what you have in your hand is data-driven decision-making. A world-class storage observability tool translates raw storage metric into actionable insights so that it can empower IT leaders to align their storage strategy with their upcoming goals. I will go ahead and talk about the role of AI in data storage observability, right? AI plays a huge part when it comes to ease of storage observability. Observability is about managing the data the storage array produces, and the entire infrastructure produces exabytes of data. It's manually impossible to observe the data with a manual way. Hence, the storage admins leverage AI in order to make storage observability and management better. Now, how does it help? Let's go to the use cases. The first one, anomaly detection. AI algorithms in observability tools can learn normal storage behavior and automatically detect unusual patterns. Example, sudden latency spikes, abnormal I/O, or capacity anomalies before they become critical issues. Second, predictive analytics. Right? AI can forecast storage growth, performance trends, and proactively do capacity planning, enabling proactive management and risk mitigation. Third is root cause analysis. A pain point for all storage admins. Instead of manually sitting through logs and metrics, storage admins can leverage artificial intelligence, which can correlate signals and across the infrastructure layers to quickly pinpoint to the root cause behind the performance issues or availability issues. And thus, it can help make storage admins' life a lot simpler. Intelligent automation. We all want our storage boxes to be plug and play, and AI can help us achieve that. AI can recommend or even trigger actions based on the data, observability data, and do load balancing or cache optimization without any human intervention, thus reducing downtime and any manual operational effort. Now, Another big pain point for storage admins is a lot of noise. All the storage boxes produce a lot of alerts because of all the components inside it. And in large environments, storage admins are flooded with alerts. Here, AI comes to your rescue. AI can filter the false positives and prioritize what is critical and surface out only what truly matters, thus achieving noise reduction. Workload optimization. Are my workloads running in the most efficient manner in a storage box? Well, it's very difficult to figure out in a manual way, but observability tools with AI can analyze user usage patterns and can suggest optimal data placement across the entire storage box to ensure that the tiering is in there to balance cost and performance. With all this in place, AI is also learning from the data that the storage boxes are producing, enabling in what I call as self-learning insights. So over the time, AI adapts to the unique capacity characteristics of your storage box. And it then uses those characteristics of your workloads and storage systems in order to improve the observability outcomes. With now that we have gone through the role of AI in storage observability, let's see about how agentic AIOps can help in storage observability much better. Now, before going there, I would like to talk about four stages of storage observability, right? Now, first is monitoring, the basic monitoring of a storage box. Second is when I start observing the data that the storage box produces and giving insights to the admin. Third one is AIOps, that I leveraged AI in order to make the storage observability experience a lot better for the admin. And then finally, agentic AIOps, where I have asked few agents to do the work for me, which with normal AI, I was unable to do. Now, what are those use cases where agentic AIOps can take the observability experience a notch better, right? Now, the first one, autonomous monitoring and response, right? Now, what does this mean? Based on the data that the observability tool is getting from the storage, it can start responding real time to the storage admin. I am getting a message that my drive is not available. So what do I do? What is my action? So it can, in a chatbot kind of manner, provide immediate response and thus help storage admins' life a lot easier. Second, a goal-driven response. Or goal-driven operations, I must say. An admin can define the goals that are needed from the observability, and when the goals are reached, the relevant agent starts responding with the admin, hence achieving the goal-driven operations. For example, if he needs a performance latency less than 10 seconds, so every time it exceeds 10 seconds, it goes and auto-corrects, and thus helping the admin not having to sit through and monitor through 1,000 alerts and doing those actions, rather trusting the agent to go see the goal and take the necessary actions, right? Now, next and the most critical, and which is currently lot appreciated by all the users is self-healing infrastructure. Now, a storage box is a complicated piece of hardware with lots of components in it and lots of software that interact with each other to give the best data storage experience. So it is going to come up with issues regularly. When the issues come up, admins run around in a team to figure out how do I resolve the issues. But if I'm able to outsource it to agents, and then they can self-correct themselves, we were basically achieving self-healing infrastructure. So whenever, let's say, for example, there is a storage drive and that failed, right? What can I do? A controller went for a toss. What can I do? A backplane had some issue. How can I heal it? So all the actions and an automated manner, if it goes for a toss, how can I self-heal them so that I can provide a best storage experience for my admin? And last and the biggest pain point, which is still not solvable by AI completely, where agentic AI can really be a lifesaver, is that it's in lifecycle management. Now, a storage admin who has 50 to 100 storage arrays has to regularly upgrade patches and the new releases, the new security fixes. And every storage vendor has a different life cycle, different release timelines. So today, admins maintain everything in an Excel sheet, manually interact with their team, what time it is coming up, then they have a downtime, they have to communicate, and it is a management nightmare. Rather, you can outsource all of it to agents. The observability tool can release the agents based on the certain storage boxes, and they can achieve a complete lifecycle management experience where the agents will automatically track the amount of arrays, their release timelines, and depending on each of the release timelines, they will take the necessary upgrade actions and send an email once that is done. If the upgrade has not taken place, they can send a communication on what the next upgrade should be and how it can be achieved. Providing a complete automated way of asset lifecycle management, eliminating hours and hours of manual effort that the storage admin puts today. And here, Agentic AIOps can be really a lifesaver.